Looking at the dollar yen here on the daily time frame, you can see that price has come up here and touched supply at the 114 area. Now, you can also see how big it goes right around the 114.66, about up to the 115.62. So we are touching supply up here, and we have kind of been jostling around in between old supply and brand new fresh demand. All right, so got a lot of overlap here on these bars here on the dollar yen. And this coming week, I don't really see a whole lot happening other than maybe price coming back here in a little bit lower into demand. Okay, but I also want to be very much aware of where this big daily supply is as well, because I could see price kind of just jostling right around. Technically, I could see it jostling around this bottom zone here at 112 down to about 111, all the way up to the 115. I could see it like kind of bouncing around in this area here. Now, because I feel like we've beaten these other previous two highs, I would like to see this thing continue to the upside in a nice like uptrend direction. But as we look at the price action overall, it's just been kind of ranging back and forth from about 105 up to the 115 area, and now we're on the high extreme of that. So I think a new uptrend could be forming. It hasn't confirmed itself by any stretch of the means yet, but these would be the three levels that I'm watching here this week. I would like to see a new uptrend form, so I'd like to see 115 get broken here this coming week. So as we talk about these three big daily demand zones and supply zones, I superimpose them on the 60-minute time frame just so that we could see the different levels that are inside each and every one of them. All right, so and as you can see that supply, we have roughly these three levels here that we're looking for the most recent newly formed daily demand zone. We have two zones inside of that big daily zone. And down below, we have about three zones down there that price is interact or that comprise this big daily zone in a fractal type way. Okay, so looking at the most two recent zones, both supply and demand here, as price is kind of bouncing back and forth. If price does come back down, I think it will find support down here at the bottom part of this zone, right around the 113.08 area. That would be really the strongest point of the newly formed demand zone. However, on the flip side, it's got a whole lot of chewing to do through if we're going to break through this big daily supply zone here. So you can see there's like four zones inside of this daily zone, and it's going to take a little bit of effort just to chew through that. So just want to be aware of where these supply and demand are coming into place. I'd be looking for price just to kind of bounce back and forth in between these two. And also be aware of this one down here that starts right around the 112.19 down to about 111.50. So that's what I'm looking at happening this coming week. Looking here on the Aussie yen, you can see that price has been making new highs here, and this is actually the highest point of the year so far. And prices moved off of that into demand. We've retested this demand a couple times, and I feel like this demand is getting weaker and weaker. So I could actually see price moving down off of this new high into the demand zone that's just below where we currently are, down into right around the 86.06 down to 85.45 purple zone down below here this week. Okay, so be looking for something along those lines to continue to happen here. Now, technically speaking, we still don't have a downtrend at all. We've been seeing price make new highs. Therefore, I'm still not seeing a downtrend yet. I want to be aware of the trend line though to the downside over here, just like so. And we'll see how things go here this coming week as price is doing its thing here, and possibly another little bounce here off of that trend line. And also keep in mind this purple zone down here below. Looking at the 60-minute time frame zones inside the big daily zones here, highlighted by the red and the green rectangles that we've superimposed from the bigger time frame, can see that we have a chocolate zone followed by a yellow zone and a couple blue zones down there. Really does look like it's weak to the downside. So again, I'm thinking that price is going to be moving downwards. Okay, that's what I would be looking for. And as price is doing its thing here, I think it could pretty easily chew through this stuff and make its way all the way down here before it really has to retest the highs again. Now, technically speaking, we are in an uptrend, so that's something to be very mindful. Always run with the trend as much as possible. I'm just saying that a lot of this stuff looks weak, so look for price to respect the big daily zone that it's currently in. But if it doesn't, then I think it could pretty easily chew through this thing and get all the way down here to demand. So the real question is, will we find support here real soon?